I'm Santosh Gaidankar. Today's concept is about the gyroscopic effect on the ship. It's an important concept in dynamics of machine. First, steering. First is the steering here. Now, this is the board here. This is the front view, this is the top view, this is the port, this is the starboard, now this is the rotor which is rotating in clockwise direction, and this is nothing but I will treat as a left and this is the right. An observer is this side, stern or aft, 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 stern or aft. The observer is this direction, he is seeing from this direction. Now this is the ship steering, we are doing it now. When it is moves towards left direction, because it is rotating in clockwise direction, this is the clockwise direction. You know only the axis here. First draw the line of axis. Next, it is rotating anti-clockwise, hold it in this way. Now thumb indicate what? Arrow, this direction, place it here. It moving towards the left, move it toward left. This is the active gyroscope, this is the reactive gyroscope. This is the active one, active, reactive gyroscope. Direction for this one, just hold this one. This finger indicate what? Direction, in this way. That's it. The indication is nothing but based upon this direction we have to say that, or this direction we call as a bow and aft. The bow rises and aft dip. Aft will be dip. The bow will rises and aft will be dip. When it is take right turn right turn towards the starboard, the same in opposite direction, the bottom means you have to hold in this way, in this way. The thumb indicate what here? The thumb indicate direction, opposite direction. Here what happened? The bow, based on this direction, the bow will be dip, aft will be rises. Bow will be dip, aft will be rises here. Okay, now this is for clockwise rotation. We have done for the clockwise rotation. If the ship moves with the rotor anti-clockwise rotation, then what happened? We have to see now. Now this is a rotor or motor which is rotating anti-clockwise, CCW. This is star board, this is port. Now observer is here, this is the observer, this is bow, this is aft or stern, this is the observer. It is rotating anti-clockwise, CCW. Now hold it in this way. We have to hold because the direction is here, it is rotation anti-clockwise, the finger has to be rolled. Therefore draw a line, but we don't know the vector representation. The thumb indicate the vector here. Now when it is moved towards the star, when it is, if you move the, if the observer is here, this side for the observer becomes the right, as per the right hand. This is the right hand and this become what? Left, similar to the aeroplane. When it moves towards the right, it moves in this way. The active will be here, the reactive will be in this direction. as the active and reactive, now rotations occur in this way. Just hold it out in this way, the rotation in this way, acting. Similarly, for when it takes the left turn or towards the port, active, reactive. As it bottoms, exactly opposite. This is towards the right, this is towards the left. Left is nothing but port, and this right is nothing but starboard. Here also, this is left, this is right. This is for steering, and there is a formula for finding this one. Gyroscopic couple. G is nothing but I omega into omega p. It can be written as m k square 2 pi n divided by 60. This is nothing but V by R Newton meter. Here m is nothing but the mass of the rotor in kg. Mass of the rotor in kg. K is the radius of gyration of rotor in meter, where n is the speed of rotor in rpm. V is the speed of the ship in meter per second, and R is the radius of curve in meter. One thing here, after completion here, the bow will be what? Based on this direction, the bow will be rises and aft will be dip. Here bow rises, sorry, bow will dip, aft rises. That is the basic concept you have to understand of the ship. Steering is completed. Now we are go for the pitching. Now in the pitching case, pitching, this is the ship. This is the port. Now exactly axis of the precision we have to take. We have to find out the angle phi. What amount it is going to pitch here in this way. This is the port. This is the star board. This is the clockwise rotation bow. This is the observer which is seeing from this one, stern or aft. When it is a clockwise movement, If up and down take place, then what happened? When it moves up, it moves in this way. Clockwise, thumb indicate direction. Next, active, This is the reactive. Active and the reactive. Now, while drawing the rotation, you have to see this one. Just hold it in this way. The thumb indicate what? Rotation. This is for us left. Just don't consider the left and up and down, just consider up and down. Okay, in this case what happened, the bow will be faces towards up and down. Up and down. First case, it's a clockwise rotation, the bow towards right side. Bow towards bow towards bow towards right side. Next here, when it is moved downward, it will move in this way. Anti-clock is over, clockwise is over, act towards the right side. Okay, the bow turns towards the right side for this first case. In second case, the bow towards the left side. Here what happened, the bow moved towards the left side, left side. Next, when it is in anti-clockwise direction, when the rotation is anti-clockwise direction, then how it goes? Now anti-clockwise I am doing it here. Everything will be same here. Phi here, this side will be star board, this is the port when it is moved viewed from the this end. This is the bow which is rotating anti-clockwise. This is the aft. When it moved up and down, when it is moved up, it moves here, arrow will be here, next arrow will be here. This is the active and this is the reactive. One more, when it is moved towards the port or dip, it will forms in this way. For this one you have to see this arrow, draw the line. For this one you have to see this one, draw this angles. Now bow towards right here, bow towards right side. In the anti-clockwise, it moves towards the right side. Now here bow move towards the left side. That's the basic explanation for this one. Formula for this one is nothing but finding the maximum pitching G max is nothing but I omega omega P max. What is this one? Mk square into 2 pi n divided by 60 into phi. Phi is nothing but the pitching angle. 2 pi tp tm, where m is the mass of the rotor, k is the radiation of the radius of gyration. M is nothing but the mass of the rotor, mass of the rotor. K is the radius of gyration. And N is nothing but the speed of rotor. Phi is nothing but maximum angular displacement of axis of the spin in radian. Well, TP is nothing but what? Time period of SHM. One more, maximum acceleration can be obtained as, this is the maximum acceleration can be obtained. Alpha max is nothing but minus phi 2 pi tp whole square. And third case is the rolling case, where the gyroscopic effect will be zero. Only the formula we can use it for this one, rolling effect. G iw omega p rolling. The formula for this one is nothing but mk square 2 pi n divided by 60 w p rolling. This is the formula. Because the gyroscope doesn't produce, gyroscope effect doesn't occur in the pen when it is rolling here. I am Santosh Gangkar. Thank you very much.